Hello, good morning students. Welcome back once again to another video for the exercise of the laws of motion chapter. Okay, so today I have another two questions for you. These are theoretical based questions and then we will start with the numericals. Okay, so the first question is, why is it advised to tie the luggage on the roof of the bus? Once again, it is the same question. Why is it advised to tie the luggage on the roof of the bus? So in the previous question, if you remember, that we have to hold in the bus, otherwise if the bus stops, we get a jerk forward, and when the bus starts, we get the jerk on the back side. So similarly, the same thing is happening for the luggage as well. So when the bus is moving, the luggage on top is also moving. So if the bus stops, then the luggage wants to keep moving by the first law of motion, that the object in motion will remain in motion. So the luggage on top of the bus wants to remain in motion, and therefore if the bus has stopped, the luggage will move forward and it will fall on the front side. So it is better to tie up the luggage than to lose it. That is why it is advised to tie the luggage. Similarly, if the bus starts, then the luggage on the top gets the jerk back side, and there are the chances that it may fall again. So it's better to tie up the luggage so that it moves firmly with the bus. So the answer for the first question is, once again, because of the first law of motion, that the luggage on top of the bus wants to remain in motion. So when the bus stops, the luggage will move forward because it wants to stay in motion. Similarly, when the bus starts, the luggage was in rest, so it wants to remain in rest, and that is why it may get the jerk backwards and it may fall again. Okay, so that is why it is advised to tie up the luggage. The next question is, a batsman hits the ball which rolls on the ground. After covering a short distance, the ball comes to rest. Why does the ball slow down the stops? So there are four options given over here. A batsman is hitting the ball and then the ball stops after a while. So why does that happen? Okay. So the answer for this is, a batsman did not hit the ball hard enough. So that is not the question. Why is it stopping down? Okay. The ball is rolling on the ground. Obviously, we know that anything that rolls on the ground, ultimately it comes to a stop. And this is what we talked about in the previous chapter, that is motion chapter, that there is always a force which opposes in the opposite direction of the motion, and that force is friction force. Okay, so because of that friction force, the ball slows down and ultimately it comes to a stop. It does not matter how hard the batsman hits the ball. Ultimately, it is going to come to a stop if it has a long enough ground, and then it will slow down and then ultimately it will stop. So it does not matter how hard the batsman hits the ball. It doesn't matter. The ball will come to a stop because there is always an opposing force on the ground, and that force is friction force. Velocity is proportional to the force? No. We have force is proportional to acceleration. Okay. And similarly, the third option, there is a force opposing the motion. So the force that is opposing the motion is frictional force. Because of this, the ball comes to a stop. So the answer is the third option. There is a force opposing the motion of the ball. Let's see the fourth option. What does it say? There is no unbalanced force on the ball, so the ball will not come to the rest. They are saying that there is no unbalanced force to the ball, but actually there is a force. Okay, that is frictional force. So the last option is not valid once again. For the third option, you can say that velocity is proportional to acceleration and acceleration is proportional to the force. So velocity is also proportional to the force. So which is once again the first answer. That is, if the batsman hits the ball with a much force, then it will have much more velocity, because there will be more acceleration. But ultimately, that velocity will come to a stop because there is another force opposing the motion. So the first option and the second option, they both have the same meaning, that if the more force is applied, then there will be more velocity. It's okay, but why that velocity is slowing down and why that velocity is decreasing and why does the ball stop? So for that, we have the third option, because that is what the question is asked. Why does the ball slow down? It has more velocity or less velocity, it does not matter. Why does the ball slow down? It slows down because there is an opposing force, and that is frictional force. I hope it is clear to students, and now we will start with the numericals. And it states that a truck starts from rest and rolls down the hill with a constant acceleration. So the truck is rolling down the hill with a constant acceleration, which means that its velocity is increasing constantly. Okay. It travels a distance of 400 meters in 20 seconds. So the distance is given and the time is given. Find its acceleration. So the first thing you have to do is find the acceleration. And the next part is find the force acting on it if its mass is 7 ton. So like I said, this chapter is related with the first chapter. And like I said, once again, the formula to find the acceleration is what you have learned in the previous chapter. So whatever you study is always going to come again and again in the next chapters. Okay, so pay attention. So over here, distance has been given and time has been given, but the acceleration is not given. That you need to find. And for that, in the previous chapter, we studied three equations. If you remember, I said that these three equations are really important. The first equation of motion, second equation, not the laws. I am talking about equations of motion. Okay. So the first equation was V is equal to U plus AT. And the second one is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And third one, V square minus U square equals 2AS. But over here, we require acceleration and distance and time have been given. So we will use the second equation, that is distance-time relation. If it was velocity and distance given, then we can use the third one. Or if time is given and velocity is given, we can find the acceleration using the first equation. But over here, we have been given distance and time. So we will use distance-time relation, that is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Over here, S is the displacement, T is the time, okay? And T square over here, once again time, initial velocity has been given to us, that is coming from rest. So the initial velocity is zero. So all you have to do is find acceleration over here, okay? Distance, now simply substitute the values because distance is already in meters. So no need to convert anything. Time is also in seconds. So again, you don't need to convert anything. Meters and seconds, they are the SI unit. If one of them is given in kilometers and or if one of them is given in minutes, then you have to convert it in seconds and kilometers into meters. Or if centimeters, then also in meters. Okay. So we will place the value of displacement, that is 400. Initial velocity is 0. So time, that is 20 seconds. Plus half. Acceleration is what you need to find. Once again, time, that is 20 seconds. So 20 square. Okay? Solving this, we get 400 is equal to 0 plus into 20 is 0. 0 plus any number is number itself. So I am removing this whole part over here because 0 plus any number is number itself. So I am just writing this value, that is half into 8. Into 20 square, that is 20 into 20, okay, and 2 tens, so what I have over here is 20 into 10, that is 200, so the next step is 400 is equal to 8 into 20 into 10, that is 200. Now I need to find the value of acceleration, so what I will do, 8 is equal to 200 in the denominator, so it will become 400 upon 200. For any of you who is not getting this, this is what I did. 400 by 200 is equal to 8. I took the 200 in the denominator, cross multiplication, and then I changed the sides. That is A in the left hand side and 400 by 200 on the other side. Zeros, 2 twos, 4. So what you get is A is equal to 2 meters per second square. Now, you have found the acceleration. This was from the previous chapter. Okay, now we are coming back to this part. So, laws of motion always have the numericals related to the motion chapter, that is the previous chapter. And similarly, once you are going to study the gravitation chapter, once again, these equations of motion will come into play. Okay, so always remember these equations of motion. Understood? So we have acceleration as 2 meters per second square. Find the force acting on it. If it its mass is 7 ton. So now that we have the acceleration, we can remove all this, so we have space for the next part of the vehicle. Acceleration A is 2 meters per second square. You need to find the force. So from the second law of motion, we have F is equal to M into A. So the formula for finding the force is F is equal to mass into acceleration. We have been given mass and acceleration, we just found out how to solve it. Okay, simply apply the values. But thing over here is, the mass has been given in tons. You will need to convert it into kilograms, because ton is not the SI unit for applying the formula of force, that is kilogram meters per second square. You need to convert this value into kilograms. So simple, 1 ton is 1000, so 7 tons is 7 into 1000, that is 7000. Simple. So I will apply force F is equal to 7 into 1000 into acceleration, that is 2. So simple multiplication, 7000 into 2 becomes 14000. So ultimately answer F is equal to 14000 newtons. Quite simple actually, but you have to understand that the second part of the numerical is very easy. The complicated one was the first part, that is finding the acceleration. So still, the numericals for the second chapter, that is laws of motion, are easy. But to find the values of velocity or acceleration and to apply them in the formula, for that you will have to remember and do the practice by yourself for the first chapter, that is the motion chapter. Okay? So again and again do the practice for those numericals, and then I will meet you in the next video. Till then, have a